Hello, and welcome to the second edition of Humaura Hangouts. This hangout, we're going to talk about the topic is World Cup cricket, and I have along with me Jagannath Pusarla, and he's the founder of Dallas Youth Cricket League, yeah? And I also have Anurag Dixit here. And as we have talked before, we have AsifMujtaba, one of the former Pakistani very talented cricket player. I know Jagannath, you've been and Anurag also, you've been interfacing with him a lot with your cricket league, and you know, can you talk a little bit about introduce him to us?
Yeah, Asif ji lives in Plano, and he's been in US for a while, and he has been helping youth cricket for the past few years, working with the youth cricket league here. Mm-hmm. And coaching a number of kids, taking them, teaching them bowling and batting skills. And the kids really love him. Mm-hmm. In the nets. And also he coaches the teams, and he has been involved in taking the teams to other tournaments in the Central West. And so they really like him. Mm-hmm. And so we are enjoying it a lot. I mean, we are blessed to have him in the Dallas Metroplex.
Very nice. Welcome to the show. That's it.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming in. Welcome to the show, Asif Bhai.
Thank you.
And we are really honored to have you sitting along with us. It's I always wanted to meet test players. Of course, I met a few, but this is the first time I'm talking to somebody from a Pakistan team. I'm excited about it. I'm sure all our people who are watching also would be loving to talk to you. Thank you for coming again. Before we, can you, which part of Pakistan are you from?
I'm from Karachi.
Okay.
I lived in Karachi, born in Karachi. Mm-hmm. Played all my cricket from Karachi.
Yeah. Okay. So how long have you been in US?
It's almost 8 years. Mm-hmm. I moved 8 years ago. Mm-hmm. When I finished my professional cricket assignments from my PIE and England.
Pakistan and, International Airlines.
Yeah, Pakistan International Airlines. Mm-hmm. And I play professional cricket in UK. Mm-hmm. And as soon as I finished there, I'm
was that county cricket?
I was a club cricket.
Club cricket. Okay, good, good. Yeah. And how? What? I mean, Jagannath already has talked about it. What have been you doing in terms of like cricket here?
Actually, when I came here, I just played in the local leagues, mm-hmm. and I was not into it much for cricket for a few years. Mm-hmm. And in 2012, in summer, mm-hmm. The DCL, like the Kulji, they were running mm-hmm. for this place. Mm-hmm. They asked me to come forward and coach their youngsters, right?
I see.
And since then, I'm with them and coaching youngsters on this platform. But I'm also coached the USA women team for one outing at Bangladesh for the T20 World Cup qualifying. Mm-hmm. Then same thing for the men's team, mm-hmm. once to Dubai, mm-hmm. for the qualifying round. And also, I'm the general selector of the NTCA and the chief coach of the Central West team. And so far, it's going on. A lot of things are there.
Very nice. On behalf of the community, thank you for doing this service for the cricket. We're all cricket fans.
It's just definitely what I have, and definitely is my duty. I just wanted to give my committee back to them.
Very nice. Let's go to the cricket thing, because we love cricket, right? So I know the little master from Pakistan, Hanif Mahmud, and there is Javed Miandar, yeah. 18 years old, 16 years old, and across the on our side we had Sachin Tendulkar. Yeah. So what's up with this subcontinental teams? And then there is another player, 18 years old, walked in 1986 to play against West Indies, I believe. So what's up with this young prodigious talent?
Actually, what happened, like in the subcontinent, if you are good at the young age, mm-hmm. they give the chance right away. Mm-hmm. Rather than the other teams like in the English and Australian, mm-hmm. they will go through the process. Okay, they will not put a youngster live right away right. in the squad. But we do put chances, and in the chances, we find some great players.
Well,
and sometimes it happens, it will not work out. But we are not afraid to give the chance to youngsters.
Very nice answer. Actually, that answers why some people like Sivaramakrishnan, I don't know if you know
him. I don't remember. Yeah.
Sivaramakrishnan was a very great spin bowler.
Yeah.
And then leg spinner, you know him, right? So what are some of your memorable performances? If I may, in 1993, I, as you know, I'm a cricket fan. So I remember listening to that commentary live. And then there was this, Richie Bernard was saying, I think Richie Bernard was on live ACB at the time. And then he was saying, it is the Australia match, 17 runs with 2 wickets in hand, last over, Australia has won the match. And then Mustaq Ahmad, I think, got first out in the first ball. So now we have 5 balls, 17 runs to play, last wicket. So what was going through that mind at the time?
Actually, of course, at that time, because I have always learned that when never stop trying, what happens, you will lose, right? Mm-hmm. But it's no harm to try,
right?
Mm-hmm. Don't ever give up that, oh, I'm not going to do it.
Exactly.
Right? Mm-hmm. In some process, I have been successful quite a number of times on those thinking, like if I go for it. Anyway, if I'm, everybody's thinking that I'm going to lose, fine.
Right.
But why not I'm going to do something that I can turn the table around.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing, 17 runs, 5 balls.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, okay, let's see. We'll play the last ball.
Mm-hmm.
And in the process, we need actually, the scoreboard showing some differently, showing 6 runs to win the game.
Right,
it's
tie the game.
Actually, it was 6 runs tie the game.
Oh.
I was, if you see that video, then I hit the CS, so I won the game.
What was that the reason why there was so much confusion?
Yeah, that's why, because of this scoreboard, something that they was showing 6. That's why when you see the video, when I hit the 6, I was running away from the game.
Wow.
Somebody, oh no, it's tied the game. Somebody is Australian player told me. Then I stopped, right?
Oh. What happened? I saw that.
Yeah. See, this I don't know about.
You see the clip, right?
If
you see the clip, it shows that we won the game. And then suddenly when I'm running, I just stop. Somebody said that, the game is tied. What happened, you know?
I see Wasim Waqar also in the dressing room.
Yeah.
Like, you know, he's excited. Then somebody told him, I guess.
Yeah, that's what's confusing.
But still, tied.
But anyway, right? Tied the game off from nowhere. And it's really, really...
Let me ask you this another question. As an Indian cricket fan, one of the... A ball which I'll never forget about is the ball from Chetan Sharma to Javed Mehra. I cannot forget it for so long, right? So what is, I mean, and then this last ball 6 on Australia against Stiva, more sweeter because it was against Australia and Stiva. Thank you for that. So now, what is up with this? That special fighting qualities which I see in some of the batsmen across from Pakistan, I mean, in India also, of course. Do you see that sort of the talent, the fighting in the current team?
Actually, this is the thing, because when that happens, when you talk about those era, that time the Pakistan, because when Javed Mehra hit the 6, the Pakistan team was a strong side.
Right.
They are winning the games, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they were in a winning streak.
Mm-hmm.
When I played the game, right, we won the World Cup.
Mm-hmm.
We just won the series against England. And we went to Australia.
Yep.
That's the winning competition, winning.
That was in 92-93.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's like the team is winning.
Right.
At this time, there is a lacking, the winning.
Mm.
The winning formula is a lacking at this time.
I see.
But like you have seen that the Pakistan cricket team is an unpredictable side.
I wanted to listen from you.
Yeah, they scored 400 one day and 150 all our second day.
Okay.
That's why we can see that, like in the 1992 World Cup, if you see that, from performance-wise, we were never there.
Mm.
Some of the situations comes up in England match. We were out for 76 something
and the
range off,
mm-hmm.
1.8, and Westerners beat the Australia,
yes,
and then something like that happened. And even on this semi-final,
mm-hmm.
when Pakistan were almost going to lose the game, and Zamana played his writer inning with Moin Khan,
right?
Then we went to the final, and we again. We did not score much against England, and
mm-hmm.
we were thinking, okay, because we don't have much bowling attack, but suddenly
mm-hmm.
Wasim Waqar strike and got 2 quick wickets, and then all...
And he was not in form till then.
Yeah.
I read somewhere that Imran Khan, Wasim Waqar said, I don't want to play today, but he was a flu or something. Is that true?
Yeah, he's a class bowler. He did on the right time.
He's a class bowler.
Yeah.
You're
but at this moment, right, of course, we don't have that batsman like who has like Javed Mehra or Imran Khan, right?
Mm-hmm.
This two are Wasim Waqar, right?
Mm-hmm.
In the bowling side, you have said we don't have any Ajmal.
Mm-hmm.
The Hafiz is not when he's out of the tournament because of the injury.
Right.
though as Ajmal has been cleared off, anyway, we can talk later about that. And but and the batting, only I can see a Yunus Khan can do the role which Javed Miada has done it, along with Ms. Bauhar. But the thing is that the record says that they were not doing as the Javed Miada was doing in while they were playing for Pakistan. He was playing for Pakistan. Okay. But it's like pieces and bits like that. We just waiting on the day when they perform.
So Asif, let me ask you this question. Yeah. Right? If you go by statistics,
right.
I think you have the highest batting average against Australia in a one-day international, right? 216. So what would be your tips, especially for the subcontinent teams going to Australia? Because as much as I've read about you, I think I don't see any of the Pakistani player done so much better against Australia. So what comes to mind, like when like let's say we have to win this cup, and this format is, in my mind, I was talking to Suresh yesterday, it's very easy. It's all about three games, right? Everybody will be in the quarterfinal, of course, for economical reasons. But what they should be thinking? I mean, one thing is positive frame of mind, but is there like a combination? What works in Australia?
Actually, the performing, first of all, when you go anything, like if you're going working in any field of life, any life, you know, anything of your engineer, doctor, anything, if you take the pressure on you, even you have a big talent, you have the ability for everything, but if you tense yourself for fearing about the result, what happened, so then you will underperform, right? If you take out your scary thing about from your heart that, okay, I'm not going to fail. If I fail, what happened? That's how, it's all part of the game. So that's the thing. But for this thing comes into the mind, a lot of out of ground things involved, right? Management, selection, captain, so many things are there.
And Imran Khan.
Yeah, Imran Khan, that's the positive captain, right? Okay, and that is all about. If you think about, okay, I'm going to play a game, do my best, just leave all the fear back in the dressing room, and that's the only thing, right? When I played that, I never fear about anything. Yeah, though I sometimes perform, sometimes I never perform, right? But it does not mean I did not try. I was about scared about my failure, right? If you see that, I'm not that like that in some of like that, but I'm satisfied with what I have done, right?
I mean, you were the vice captain at some point.
Vice captain of Pakistan for 1 year. But that's what I'm saying. I never fear about the failure. If it happened, what happened? That's okay.
It really reminds me of my university coach in Division 1. He said, you know, cricket is played above this.
Yeah. Okay. That's right.
You know, above the shoulder. That's how you.
So play. You have one advantage, Asif, which is you never needed to face probably Wasim Akram, Wakarina, Akib Javed, at least at the test level. At the test level. So you can say that there is no.
No, at that time, if you see when I played, I played against the. West Indies bowling
right.
at that
yeah.
time.
They were still there.
When I was make a test debut on the age of 19, right? Malcolm Marshall was there, Courtney Walsh was there.
There.
Then later on, the Bishop comes and
Cuddy
improves. And this is the only one. And if other team you see, they don't have any bowler. Like in Australia, there were only McDermott was that time, right?
Yes.
Bruce Reed. But they were not that.
Right.
But they would be successful in certain kind of pitches, right?
So I have this question always. See, does Pakistan have any secret bowling fast bowler generation factor or something?
It's not really actually. If you see, I'm going to give you an example, right? Since the era of Cuddy, Ambrose, the Courtney Walsh passed, right, we don't see any fast bowling from the West Indies, which we're supposed to, like from the Wesley Hall till that.
Yep.
Yeah.
We have always a fast ball.
Right.
Sometimes it comes like the fall of the Roman Empire, you know, something like that. Now we are going on this part because we have produced the top fast bowlers. Now we don't have any fast bowlers. Right, and it's very strange that if you go for top 10 fast bowlers of the world, no Pakistanis are there.
Yeah.
Right, because now it's going down. It happens.
In fact, I was looking at the statistics, and now with Junaid Khan out, and you know Hafiz being out, and you know no Saeed Ajmal, You know, the highest wicket taker right now is Shahid Afridi, around 300.
Oh, we'll talk about Shahid Afridi, believe me. Because I remember Shahid Afridi is the youngest cricketer at any point in time. I mean, every time I see, he's still an young player, is what I see. So let's come back to the current World Cup. Before we do that, I'll just ask one more nostalgic question, because I love that era, right? You are a part of the, I think, one of the strongest team. I mean, in fact, I think it is the strongest team at that time, 1992. Arguably one of the strongest Pakistani teams ever. You had Imran Khan, you had Javed Miandad, you had Wasim Akram, yourself, Waqar Yunus, Akif Javed, Salim Malik, Saqlin. And then all this, right? Yeah. So how was it in the dressing room?
Yeah, actually, being as a younger player and something like that, you know, it's always like, might be at this time now, the dressing room atmosphere is a bit more relaxed, you know. Mm-hmm. But at that time, when the senior players like them, then we, as a younger player, we have to be like you know, sitting against the, in front of your elders and everything. You know, don't do anything like that. Which is
what about the current day political leader we have there sitting there?
That is always, but that is also good, because it gives you discipline in your life.
Yes.
That's you have true. Seen that. Have you seen that that era, the scandals and the other things are very less now? After that, you're coming up, because when you're free, if you give you some liberty, mm-hmm. then sometimes you misuse that.
So they're too relaxed. Sometimes they're having these fights.
Yeah, it happens, you know. But in that, when we have in control, of course, like when I know everybody says Imran Khan was so strict. Of course, for is the betterment of the team, right?
Okay.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
He just need to win the game.
Okay.
Right.
Yep.
He does not ask you what you do. Mm-hmm. He just asks you what you want, what you have done in the ground.
Okay.
Right. That's the thing. But of course, the whatever you're doing off the field is will reflect on the ground. Right.
You can't party all the way in the night and come back and.
It is related to that, you know.
Definitely.
So if you have discipline, you show your discipline in the ground as well. It will not. You're not disciplined, and you can how you can show the discipline. Maybe one or two game or something that can discipline, but. It's come reflect all the things, right? But it's very, very good for that time that it teach you discipline.
Okay. So let's come to the topic of interest here, right. Which is the current World Cup. So I cannot help but put it this way. So far, India has played with Pakistan in the World Cup 5 times. India has played, as I said, with some of the strongest Pakistani teams, and a few of the weakest Indian teams played against the strongest teams. But somehow, India found a way to win the matches in the World Cup.
Right.
What is your...
Actually, you know, if you see that the previous matches, that is at this World Cup, India is going to face the weakest Pakistan side.
Yes.
Before that, they always face the strongest Pakistan side. Yep. Right?
Good point.
And after you see that Pakistan lose against India in all the World Cup matches, but the Pakistan team bounced back. That.
Right.
Because it's a strong side, of course, they will lose the game, whatever the elements required, you are so tense against India or something like that. But at this time, the point is this, for India is upper, and it's because of that they are facing against the weakest Pakistan ever in the World Cup, right? But the one day cricket, as Pakistan said, you never know.
So they don't have the underdogs tag this time.
No, India.
That's what the point is.
It would be good side, because, and also, India is not the strongest side as should be.
Yes.
Both are equal. It's not India versus.
So we both are competing with each other on putting the fittest team there.
Right.
Yeah, I heard today Muhammad Hafiz is not with the team.
Not with the team, because,
it's interesting you put the word tension in there. Is there because we all don't know, we can all predict, but you know you are in the trenches there.
Yeah.
Is there really a tension? Is there really a tension in the team? I'm sure the same thing will be in Indian team also, I'm sure, whatever you say. Is there really tension in the minds of the cricketers also?
It happens because, you know, suppose if you are living in an environment, right, if so many things are going out, tense out on your outside, you will reflect you, right? Because it is not, if the people of subcontinent are relaxed, players are relaxed.
We are not.
So that's the thing, right? Everyone always comes, right? They want to see that, okay, if you are from India, oh no, you don't have to lose against Pakistan. If you are from Pakistan, oh, you don't have to lose against India.
Baki World Cup, haar jaye, no problem, but beat India.
Whatever, yeah. Jo bhi ho, aisa hi ho. Theek hai na? So, lekin that is very good. Actually, I played a lot of games against India, especially in Sharjah. I played against India most of the games in Sharjah when we have the Sharjah Cups, yeah. right? And koi aaye kehta hai, "Oh, yaar, koi bhi aaye, match nahi hai. We don't care about any other thing." Right?
No, I remember we used to call Sharjah as Harja. That World Cup was for our Jeet
Jai. Yeah, that is actually, I don't know why
it's
funny.
But it used to be like, one of those, you know, like jinx.
Right.
You know, if you go to Sharjah, you're going to lose. But if you go to World Cup, then yeah. Pakistan is going to lose. So and
yeah, just like sometimes you say very strange.
Do you think it's still there like that? How does it come down a little bit?
That, no, it's still always there.
It is still
there. You see that, why that first game, India and Pakistan of the World Cup? Why is that on the weekend? Why is that weekend on every
somebody
part
knows,
of every...
Somebody knows how to make money.
Every part of the corner is weekend, right?
Right.
Somebody was telling me who's the bigger, like, Super Bowl compared to World Cup. Are you crazy? Talking about the Pakistan-India World Cup with the Super Bowl?
Not even
Indian
close.
Population is more than 1 billion. Pakistani population is 300 million, yeah. right? The other people are watching that.
Right.
And you're talking about Super Bowl to compare with it?
There is no...
How you come this comparison?
Not even close.
Not even close, then.
Almost like 25% of the world population.
No, let's get Chinese also.
That's why how kind of this is like, you know, strange. But people said throw the question there. No, yeah. With no chance.
So yeah, coming back again, the strength, I mean, if at all there is a strength, the strength of the Pakistan team is bowling. And the strength of the for lack of a better word, the strength of the Indian team is in the batting, obviously, in this World Cup also. So let's see how the strength of Pakistan's bowling pit against the Indian batting lineup. So let's talk about the Pakistani bowling.
Right. Actually, at this time, it's slightly changed.
Mm-hmm.
Because you don't have the two bowlers, right? So Hafiz and Saeed Ajmal. Because 20 overs is very vital in the one-day games in the previous matches. When
Junaid Khan also.
Junaid Khan, but I'm not considering him as like...
Okay. The real impact players.
Yeah. Okay. Because this, in the middle, like, these two bowlers are always made an impact, right? Of course, Junaid Khan is there, but Junaid Khan was in and out for a while, right? At this time, if you compare with the bowling and batting, batting is slightly better at this time.
Interesting.
Yeah, I'm telling you.
Okay.
Because we have, if you see this, that is Shahid Afridi, the highest wicket taker.
Right.
And if you see the graph, all the other players, bowlers have played 1 1-day, 2 1-day, 3 1-day,
yes.
That is the weakest, right?
Inexperience.
Inexperience, right? Mm-hmm. Of course, inexperience, if you play less matches, you will not take much wickets, right?
Yeah.
Okay. If somebody played two, like all the players has played few 1 days, right?
Right.
If you go to the other baller line. But in the batting side, all the batsmen have played number of matches. That's why I'm comparing this, how much of experience we have and how much in the bowling, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if you see that in the bowling line, that only that maybe at this time, the spinner Shahid Afridi always there, that Irfan.
Mm-hmm.
There will be
Mohammed Irfan. Yeah, that was
Irfan. The short guy?
No,
the college guy.
Again, because the bowlers are trying their best.
Mm-hmm.
It depends how the other batsman played.
Yeah.
Sometimes you bowl well, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the batsman tackle you intelligently, they will not get the wickets.
Okay.
Sometimes you bowl well and the batsman play stupidly, right? Something like that you get the outs on. Because as a coach, I always say, okay, please put your price on the pitch, on the wicket.
Okay.
Don't get out on the bad balls.
Okay. So coming back again to what we'll talk about the pace bowling, because I feel one of the weakest links in the Indian right now is at the top of the order. It's a strong also and the weak also we have. So do you see, especially with Irfan Khan being like very tall, I heard he's taller than Dirk Nowitzki.
It's 7-1.
He's
seven
taller
one.
Than Dirk Nowitzki
it's
or
seven
maybe 7-1, right? Yeah. So imagine 7-1 guy on a bouncy Australian pitch hurling the ball at you, right? So.
But the thing is, the Adelaide pitch is not as bouncy as you're supposed to.
Yes.
Because Adelaide is more like a batting or a spinner pitch. Right?
That's a good
you
point.
You saw that last night.
This match is evenly poised, you know, because it's not like that someone is strong or someone is weak, right?
Okay.
But if we go for the bowling line, right, of the Indian team, that is, and against this better batting line as compared to bowling of Pakistan team.
Mm-hmm.
So it depends who will. Comes out mentally strong in the game.
Yes.
That will make effect.
See, and
if you are tense, if you are...
Tense is the keyword.
We're tense like that. And of course, the thing is that because both games are very important.
Right.
right? Mm-hmm. In the view of the people, right? And it will create a confidence level. How? If you win the game, mm-hmm. then you know, win the game, any team, right? The media, people, like that.
It's a positive energy.
Yeah, coming into your mind. But it depends. Okay. Whoever, of course, anybody, one team is winning. Whoever lose the game, that is the responsibility of the management, that they will not. But you know what happened? Mm-hmm. When something happened, we asked our players not to watch news, mm-hmm. not to read newspapers.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well,
because do not see anything. Yeah,
okay, they're burning the house, I mean, throwing stones and houses, okay, attack.
India is more than.
Okay.
More than
us.
It's happened only once or two, but it's never been happened. But India, I feel, because when I heard that somebody has done with Dhoni and other players, man, look, they win a lot for your country, right? If they're not successful in one or two games, how you can react like this?
Actually, I got this question. Whenever we talk about this India-Pakistan game, there's never been like a team performance as far as I've seen. It's always been like an X factor which comes up.
Sachin Tendulkar?
Yeah, I mean Sachin or somebody like a Gautam Gambhir would come. Mm-hmm. So in your mind, right, and I have my own answer, but for Pakistan, I've always seen there's somebody X factor which comes in and can take the game away. So who are like the two players or three players you think?
Well, you know, always Shahid Afridi.
Yes.
You know, he's always an X factor. He doesn't do on every game, but you have seen so many times he did it.
Yes.
Right? You never know, especially because supposedly if you are, if you need 50, 60 runs in few overs, that is the X factor when Shahid can do it. But if you suppose Shahid come to bat for 35 overs to go and chasing 175, that is not the case. Shahid will be more effective when you score 60, 70 runs in few overs, that is. Mm. But if you go a longer version, then it's very, very, very weird that he will come off. And the other player would be for the one. If I'm thinking about that, guys, I didn't see much this Yasir Shah light on leg spinner. I don't know how they can take him like that and how he's bowling, but like in the 92 World Cup, Mujtaba was surprised when he had two wickets tied. He can do the same thing in for Pakistan if they allow him to play, if he can give a chance to play.
Two leg spinners in the team.
No, that's fine, because spinners in Adelaide pitches can be helpful.
One of the players, like the bowler side, I feel is Wahab Riaz. You know, especially even if you...
Actually, you know what, Anurag? One of the questions I asked him was, is there some bowler you wrapped around in the wool, didn't tell all of us, a surprise bowler?
Yeah, that's why I say, if they give a chance to Yasir Shah,
so,
because the relaxed spinner is always an attacking bowler.
So there you go, the answer for that.
Then, though he can be expensive, but he can take wickets. Mm-hmm. Because I would not mind if a bowler hit by two sixes and batsman give him a wicket. I'm very happy to give 12 runs and get one wicket. If he took four wickets for 60 runs, right? Or 70 runs, four vital wickets, match done.
Yeah, I mean, if you just take a...
You know what I mean? Yeah. You can, if you see that 70, if he gives 70, others give 71, 40, and top four wickets have been gone, so maybe you end up at 250. Yeah. And 250 is nominal.
Like, coming back to that thing,
yeah.
Put on your batting hat. So you have like three left-arm pace bowlers, and our Indian opener in trouble right now is Shikhar Dhawan. So is there some what happens in the what is this thing about the left-arm bowlers, and then is there anything difference in the left-hand batsmen and you know all that stuff?
No, because as a bowler, if some a left-hand batsman in a team is always distributed. Mm. If as a bowler, if you're a left-arm bowler. Mm. Bowling a right-hand batsman is always disturbing.
I see.
Because like if you've seen in the past when the Australians have five or six left-hand batsmen, four batsmen in the lineup, and it's a nightmare for the bowlers.
Yeah.
Nightmare for the captain. Nightmare for the field. It's always a different, because there's different, different trajectory, different everything, and different angles, right?
Yes.
Different angles. It's always.
Especially you yourself is a left-hand bowler and a batsman, right? So and when I play, especially whenever the left, I. So it's the blind spot they create.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, guys. Welcome back again to the cricket hangout, Humaura Hangout. We are with Asif Mustafa, Pakistani test player, and I also have Anurag here. Let's continue on the discussion. We started talking about the World Cup match, the first match, the marquee match we have been waiting for. And Asif was saying, you know, there's not too much tension in those matches, right? And surprisingly, it looks like he's more comfortable with the batting now than the bowling. But still, size as small. I can say this because I'm Singh. So we are planning on getting Yuvraj Singh by injuring someone, right? Are you guys doing anything like that to get size as well?
Actually, it cannot be because, you know, if you want to do like that, okay, I'll get somebody injured. It will not because, you know, it has to be go through the medical panel that, okay, is it a real injury or not? Are you going to make a fake injury like that? But like... medical panel says that you have to approve that, then you can do it. But even if something happened like that, I don't think so the Pakistan team management is comfortable to getting Saeed Ajmal.
I see.
Because they don't know about that with the new action, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. How much he's effective.
I see.
Right? Because he's more effective when he's bowling Dusra.
I see.
Right? Mm-hmm. When he's bowling Dusra, then we have to check it, okay, what kind of angles are there. If he's cleared, and if they think they can see them and see him and then analyze how much effective, but at this time, Chandrasmal is not on the card.
Not on the card, because interesting. I'll just take a small this thing and understand this whole thing about Dusra from a batsman's perspective. And what is it basically?
Dusra, why is actually, it what happened? You know, is what happened actually. Normally, an off spinner when ball a Dusra like is called the fluter, right? When it goes away, like not off spin, like leg spin, right? But Dusra means what happened when Saqlan playing with Moin Khan, Moin Khan behind the stumps, so in the Urdu language, okay, yaar, Dusra kar de.
Achha.
Dusra kar. So this become a Dusra.
Nah, Dusra ball karna.
Nah, Dusra away, not off spin, Dusra. So kya Dusra kar. So wo that's वहाँ से फिर वो ये दूसरा invent हुआ word के दूसरा the people know about दूसरा word. Actually, दूसरा is the Urdu word के दूसरा different करो तो वो वहाँ से दूसरा है. दूसरा जो है जो ball है वो totally different होता है. It is, in my opinion, the way is दूसरा is going to bowl, you have to bend your elbow.
I see.
Because the only bowler was Saqlan Mujtaba, then he can bowl Dusra without bending the elbow.
Including Murali Dharan.
Yeah. Murali Dharan was also doing that.
I
would agree. But it's why that time it was not been right. So. Not, it happened because sometimes the error here in Australia is called no ball and some controversy again.
Right.
And that time is no much effect, not much effect implemented by the ICC at the time. But now, if Saqlan, if you see, complain, if you watch the Saqlan video of Dusra and the other bowler, bowler often bowling Dusra, it's totally different. Because when Saqlan bowls Dusra, it comes slow. When he's not bending the arm. When the other bowlers, now this is bowling Dusra, it comes faster.
I see.
But when bowl Dusra, you have to turn around all the evidence, so it's reduce the pace.
I see.
Right? It's reduce the pace, that's why it's Saqlan was slower than Dusra was slower. The ball was cutting away the same way, but slowly speed. Now it's time that the bowling they have.
So with the Dusra removed from the armor of Sajid, probably he might not be as effective.
Let's see how maybe he will effectively change something because he's been corrected by the Saqlan.
I see.
That is a key point because I'm really happy that Saqlan worked him for 35 weeks and now he's clear.
I see.
Right.
Okay.
So because his Saqlan is doing a lot of coaching in England and he's preparing. Even he was done with the Bangladesh and he's quite successful with the bowlers. And his the results are there that he's been cleared. Okay. But the thing is that when he bowls again the match, how much is effective?
Yeah. The last thing. Yeah. I mean, I'm sure it is different when you bowling to get yourself tested versus when you go in the field and you're trying to bowl.
But one thing also that by that time. He will be reported again, he will again report.
Old habits, right? Old habits will come in. Right?
But once you clear it, mind you, because once you clear it by the ICC, it's very, very a fine line than somebody again reported Saeed Ajmal.
And now the umpires have the backing,
yeah, because
right?
Because, oh, Saeed, ICC already something I'm going to call, report him again.
Yeah.
It's something like offset politics, right? That you can call him again, report him again, like that. who's it, then everybody like strong boards of them, they will.
So like once somebody's tagged criminal, then they become like in the eyes of the police.
Definitely,
like,
oh, that's not right.
Yeah. So do you, bring and on the same Dusra question you had, you've seen Ashwin in your team. So is that Dusra or Karambol? What's there?
Well, Ashwin, Dusra and Sajman Dusra is quite different.
I see. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And Ashwin is slightly taller than Ajma. Mm-hmm. So he has slightly long. He also, he can be reported anytime, tell me.
Yeah. Right. Oh, I see.
He can report anytime.
Watch Ashwin.
Yeah. He can be reported, but it's not much as like a depend upon how. It's depend upon the on field and the match referee. But it's Ashwin Dusra. And the Sayyid Ajmal Dusra is quite different. Ashwin, Sayyid Ajmal Dusra cut a long way, right? Ashwin Dusra is not much as effective as Sayyid Ajmal was there, but he's doing well because a small cut is more dangerous than a bigger cut.
I see.
Right. Because bigger, when the ball cut more, the batsman, you can beat the batsman. You touch not the bat or anything.
And you're not.
Yeah. Yeah. So Ashwin is there. And because if he's trying to do anything, but he has also, I'll do that, maybe I'll call, I may be reported, you know.
I see.
But that's why the coaches of the team, your team are working on him that, okay. And confine him that.
Careful, man.
Careful
so,
about that.
Talking about, since we are talking about spinners, I know it's not as conducive in Australia now, it's for spinners, but across all the teams today, can you pick like one or two spinners whom you think are might have some impact?
Really, is there is nothing.
No, okay. All right.
But
so,
what if Wasim Narayan is playing there?
He's not there.
Yeah, he's not.
But let me ask
he put himself out, you know, he said that, yeah.
Let me ask you this question, and we debated about this yesterday in the first hangout is, you know, when we talk about spinners in Australia, I mean, there are two theories, right? One, the ball is not going to spin. And the other theory, the grounds are so big, the spinners might come into play. So I don't know which side.
Actually, if you've seen that in the previous...
Deepak Patel case from New Zealand, you remember in that World Cup.
Yeah. But he, because he doesn't, he was like quite penetrative in the ball, And but if you're saying that the wrist spinner, like leg spinner, is always effective at every pitches.
Yes.
Right? You see the Mushtaq Ahmed or when even Danish Kenny or Shane was playing, when Kumbli was playing, and everything is leg spinner is always effective as compared to the finger spinners, right?
Mm-hmm.
Finger spinners at this time, then I cannot see anything that would be very much impact on that. Even in Pakistan team, Shahid Afridi is always effective, right? Rather than another one, right? Finger spinner can contain the score rate for a while, but at this time, the cricket has changed, then it's always good when you take wickets.
So the size of the ground may not matter, because the way I look at it, the new rules, right? They put only 4 fielders outside. There's a tendency now I can hit, especially if you just have a long on, long off, and like a cover point and a
Day by day, they are making... making difficult for the bowlers. First they prepare for the fast bowler, one for the bouncer.
Okay.
Then one bouncer. Right? Why is that? I really don't like it personally. Right? You want for the bouncer. If you want to bowl six bouncer.
No, I like it coming from a batsman actually.
Yeah, I'm coming from nice. I don't like this one bowler because I don't want, because the cricket is a game you cannot restrict anybody. If you play any game, you can play with a game which is allowed. Right, any game is allowed. If your one bouncer is allowed, it means they're allowed.
I think it's all about that 100 rupees and that 1.3 billion people, you know, which is sick.
I'm saying, because if a bouncer is allowed in the game of cricket, why not six?
Okay.
I do not agree with this ICC regulations. One ball for the one bouncer for over. After that, if you can ball one bouncer, then you'll be, the batsman, oh, his bouncer is not coming, right?
And now especially they came like knights, you know, with the helmet, the arm guard,
because
everything.
The thing was, because before that was not,
exactly.
When the body line language has been established, when the Bradman era, right? Mm-hmm. Body line.
Yeah.
You know the history of the body line? I know it's coming of the body line, which I come to know in the BBC video like that.
Douglas Jordan.
Happened when somebody was sending a telegram or telex, so he put it all the, if I'm right, if I'm wrong, anybody can correct it on the online, something like that. That somebody is writing a text, right, telegram or something at the time, you know. So he does not have enough money. I can describe that phrase to send this telegram. So he said body line bowling. That comes from there. The body.
Interesting.
That's what I see.
The line of the ball should be on the body.
Yeah.
That's why
they don't have the money to send this massive.
That's interesting.
That is where about that long time now about I've seen somewhere, right? Mm. Where it says cut it and then say body line.
Wow.
But that's because he does not have enough money to send a telegram to somebody, right?
No, but the thing is, emotions and things like that coming from the Indian subcontinent is, I think it's very known. But when all this, like 3-4 months back, I know there was a travesty happened in Australia. It was interesting, like they were talking about. Coming back to this match again, we talked about from the Pakistan perspective, right? So now let's see what you're the Pakistan team now. What do you think, specifically in the Indian batting we're talking about, who are your, analyze the Indian batting lineup from a Pakistani perspective.
Right, it's a big difference between Pakistan batting line and the Indian batting line. Indian batting line is very strong. Mm-hmm. Though, of course, some hiccups are there, right? Yeah. But it's still, batting line is strong. You have a strong batsman who will perform well under the different situation, difficult situation. Mm-hmm. First of all, you have a very good, dependable, motion control player in face like of Dhoni is there, right?
Mm.
Though somebody people don't like him, I don't know why.
Interesting, you picked Dhoni first.
Because he's coming in number six, right? Mm-hmm. That some current situation, he's the man of steel, I'd say that. You know, he's a. But I like him very well.
Who better can you tell that 5 and 6, right?
Right. Because, you know, normally, when it's coming in that time, that Dhoni can play a vital role, right?
Mm.
And if the top batsman played, then it's very good, of course.
Mm-hmm.
But on the Australian pitches, the things comes. You see that I might be, it's just myself, and I that the point comes to Dhoni in the batting.
Mm.
Okay, will get a chances more than anybody else to match the turnover.
To consolidate, basically. Yeah. There is a possibility.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
There is a possibility that top order wickets can go down, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
And Dhoni's composure at that point, fifth and sixth, five down, six down, that probably will be.
Because he is the tendency that even he play with the tailenders, but he batted around the tailenders.
Mm-hmm.
And that is a quality.
I see.
Because if two batsmen are playing from both hands, it's not a big deal,
right?
Mm-hmm. When one batsman and one talent are playing, and then batsmen are use this talenter, how they use it, right?
Mm-hmm.
That is the quality.
And one thing is, as you know, Sachin is not there. I mean, there's an interesting statistics I read. Every match so far between India and Pakistan, Sachin Tendulkar was there in the World Cup. So I'm just trying to give you more reasons for you to be optimistic now, I guess.
I'm optimistic about that because that's why I've said earlier, it's an unpredictable team and can't do anything, right?
So since Sachin is not there, anyway, we can talk about it. There's nothing we can do there. So I'll allude to the name also. He is basically associated with a Bollywood star also. You know whom I'm talking about. What do you think about, because I have to ask that question, Virat Kohli.
Because when he was not performing, that Bollywood star making it, impact on his performance. I don't think that is the case, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Because if the Bollywood star was there, right?
Mm.
Okay, consider about that. Who has their wives? Same thing, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that is a thing because you have means they are away from the cricket.
Mm-hmm.
If you have wives in the tour, definitely you are not spending
more troubling to have wives in the tour, I guess. No?
Right? Because somebody is not doing well now. When he's scoring centuries, then when why not that comes up, right?
Yeah.
Because this is also the media, because they need the news.
Right.
they have to sell the news, right?
That's right.
It's all media. If you have seen that, if they don't use, they created news, right?
Okay.
But it's not. I don't think so. Anything.
Anyway,
he was doing that. He was the way he performing after that. All this happens with him, right?
Right.
And you can see that how much he is strong. From here.
Yeah, that's actually this is all a joke on lighter when we are talking.
Yeah.
I know this is all not. Virat Kohli seemed to, excellent form before the one day started and all. But it's a little bit uncomfortable as an Indian fan here sitting, like how Virat Kohli is not playing good in the recent one days and all. So how do you see like that too?
No, because if he has performed well, some matches can be, because when I say it, when I'm talking to the captain or a coach, right, when mm-hmm. I when a batsman is batting, mm-hmm. I always tell them, mm-hmm. when you are set, mm-hmm. finish the inning. Mm-hmm. Because you have to cover your failed innings. Mm-hmm. But you have to fail.
Yep.
You have to fail.
You'll fail.
So you have to, when you are set, you take the best, most advantage of your form.
When
you're
there.
Much as possible. Because you have to fail. You have bound to fail. Mm-hmm. Right? That is maybe good that he failed in this innings, mm-hmm. and in the crucial match he come back again, right?
Law of averages,
right? Mm-hmm. So the talent is there,
mm-hmm. yeah,
right? The only the execution, right?
Okay,
it's not that he cannot be, he's not going to perform from X factor. No, it's not correct.
So apart from Dhoni and Kohli, we talked about, which other Indian batsmen do you pick from the lot? I mean, who any other?
Just on a daily basis or on a day to day matches or something, anybody can do it.
Okay,
right. Mm-hmm. Anybody can do it. But I'm looking for the Virat, that is mm-hmm. the key point, like a backbone of that that who can mm-hmm. The batsman can play around them, right? Yeah. And if you give a start in the opening thing, then it will be yeah. very very good for them.
That brings to another see if you can help Dhoni here, which is you know, one of the questions that everyone is discussing about is, should Kohli come in one down, which is what he used to do, and in or let him come at two down. What is your take as a like, you know, should the best batsman come in and maximum utilize the worst?
Depend upon who's in confidence. Mm. You know, if somebody, okay, if you're a top batsman, mm-hmm. but your confidence level is down, if you're putting on a difficult situation, it means you're putting him again in the deep water, right? Mm-hmm. Somebody like you have good confidence, your confidence scoring runs, you can utilize that giving opportunity and save your best talented player for his confidence down.
Okay.
We have to play around those. It's not necessarily if you are somebody is very good, but what about his confidence? What about his performance? What about his form? Mm. If somebody is performing well, mm. you can use those things mm-hmm. to get the maximum result of your team, which mm-hmm. is you have at this that time.
I see.
But it's not something if Virat is not scoring runs. Mm-hmm. Right, mm-hmm. so you can send, you get people asking for number three or mm-hmm. again. Mm-hmm. You can do it when you can change the batting order if you're given 50, 60, 70 and it's stuck. Okay, Virat, you go.
Right. Okay. That but if flexible.
He's always flexible. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the people, the batsmen, did not play on a certain numbers. This is only excuses by the batsmen. Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. If you play as a professionally, mm-hmm. and you're a batsman, you cannot complain mm-hmm. that my number is not set. You're not playing an amateur, you're not playing park cricket. Mm-hmm. You're a professional. You have to play 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever the captain and coach yeah. requires you. Yeah. That is only the excuses not to perform.
Okay. Let's quickly also, since we are running on the top of the hour, so let's do this also. Now let's look at the other half of the thing, which is the strongest Indian part, which is the Indian bowling versus in Pakistani batting. So I heard Muhammad Hafiz is not going to be there, right. Not the opener, it's not going to be. So what is happening? I mean, what's your
thing? Because I have just read that news this morning, right? The Hafiz is out because of his injury, and Nasir Jamshed came in, and some of the people asked me about, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, why not Hafiz and put Syed Ajmal in there? Mm-hmm. Because Hafiz was not bowling, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. He was playing as an opener. Mm-hmm. Pakistan replaced with an opener.
Nasir Jamshed.
Mm-hmm. That's why. If Hafiz is bowling, uh-huh. so is it possible then you can ask Syed Ajmal?
Right.
Because they have the opener, can put Faraz or any other mm-hmm. for them mm-hmm. opener. But they, because as far as Syed is, Hafiz is not bowling, mm-hmm. so he's considered an opener. That is replaced with an opener.
Okay. Yeah.
And it's really sad because he's an experienced player. He's just he's captain of the side on some occasions, and we are not compared with Nasir Jamshed to Hafiz at this time, because Nasir Jamshed did not play it mm-hmm. in the recent, you know, for Pakistan, but he did well against India, you know, mm-hmm. in the maybe that is the fact as well.
Probably,
centuries, you know,
probably that's
no, it. I always think that, you know, like any
and game, he's also left hand batsman, is maybe
somehow, you know, the India Pakistan, some players will come up, you know, especially not talking about the whole middle order. This time, my inkling is with Kohli, Raina, and Dhoni. I mean, you got three players who kind of come up to the big occasion, you know, they kind of come up, yeah. you know, and they're less under pressure. But to your point, the key is how we open them.
Yeah.
And again, my bet is on Wahab Riaz. You know, somehow that bowler, you know, that left-handed, you know, comes in.
Of course, that's a good point. Yeah, also about the batting, if you continue on the discussion. So you have, I cannot help but quote Misbah ul Haq, he's still the rough man, right? Misbah and Humaura Hangout. Do you have any comment on that?
Because Humaura Hangout is a very talented player. Yeah. That's why he got a chance again.
Mm-hmm.
Because of his talent,
mm-hmm.
and everybody thinks that he can change the game anytime.
Mm-hmm.
So we are hoping that he can do something in the World Cup.
So I feel like he's the Rohit Sharma version of.
I like that comment.
Misbah Haq also is like if somebody will play around him.
Yes.
So we can score runs, right?
Okay.
This thing, first of all...
Do you see Yunus Khan on that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I told you, because Yunus Khan is also... But he did not do well in the recent one-day internationals. And a lot of criticism of his on his selection because being a one-day player, mm-hmm. he always performing well in the test matches. So now there's a time that he can play the role played by Javed Miadad in 1992. Yeah. He has the ability... And he's the courage and everything there. And let's see how he played there.
Very interesting. Javed Miandad, roughly around at the same time, retiring.
He was injured.
Right. And he was not
playing. Before the World Cup.
Yes. So talking about Misbah ul Haq, like, I was a big fan of him when he started. And then, you know, especially after the T20 World Cup final. And then now I see a very different kind of Misbah ul Haq who wants to just stay. And before that, this guy was like more about
hitting
everything out of the park. So what changed? I mean, he seems to be like,
he's a captain,
you know,
because he's the captain responsibility. But that's what I'm saying. Because if you're a batsman, you say, oh, I cannot stop, I cannot hit. You have to do it according to situations, right?
Mm-hmm.
Normally he batted on a difficult situation. That's why he changed his batting style. But you see that he scored the fastest century on the test match.
Okay.
Right, he scored the fastest century test match, right?
Mm-hmm.
So he has the ability to defend, attack, everything, right? But see, what is the situation around him? Because he is attacking, he attacks the ball when everything is going fine. He can defend the pitch or defend his wicket and long with when there is requirement.
Mm-hmm.
So he's the also the key, like Yunus Khan, him. And I would like to see Sarfraz in batting.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm really doubt because the pitch, bounce of the pitch, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Right. He's gutsy.
Mm-hmm.
He can play shots. So in like Dhoni is playing in the number 7, he can play in the number 7 as well, or 6. So he can play also, and when the acceleration required, he can do it.
See, I caught on to that key word, which is gutsy.
Yeah.
You know, and when I look at the Indian lineup, there's this new player called Stuart Binney, who seems to be very gutsy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I think to me that is the key for this game. Guts
means like courage, right?
Yeah.
You can do I'm not, because I have seen so many players that who are most talented players, but because they don't have the strong mental ability or guts, they did not become a good player. I have known a lot of players who are not much talented, but because of the guts and their hard work, they become a good player.
Mm-hmm.
And perform.
So now I know the answer for this question, because if it comes from the heart, I know the answer for it, so I'll still ask the question. And remember, before asking that question, I'll make one comment which Jagannath is telling me. India is playing 2 warm-up matches in Adelaide, which is where we are going to play with Pakistan 1 week from now. So who do you pick? Who is winning? Who do you pick? Of course, you pick Pakistan. Who is winning?
Because as I said, that both teams are playing not as they were strong in the past, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because statistically, you see that the India playing already game at 2 and game at a delay.
Mm-hmm.
They know, of course, Pakistan has played there, right?
Mm-hmm.
As a much, I would say 60-40.
Okay.
60% chances for India and 40% chances for Pakistan. So 20% I'm doing that. Who will do like 1-2 quick wickets,
mm-hmm.
2 good overs in batting, and that's the game has changed.
I want it 50-50 because I'll be there and I want to be a photo finish till the end.
No, it's a photo finish, right?
That's all I want.
So, and also,
I will say, because maybe the Pakistani fans are watching me, or the Pakistani, I'm saying, why I'm giving 40%? Because I'm going about what is the performance of Pakistan team is going on.
See, this is the thing I like about Asif bhai. You know, like anytime I talk to you, even like we meet all the time, you know, off the camera at DYCL, the way Asif Bhai approaches, like, very humble and like a very, like, you know, statistical base, you know, you're always very, like, to the point as to what it looks like.
Yeah, because, okay, as a Pakistan, I say, okay, Pakistan win the game, I know, I want to win Pakistan in the game, but when you ask me questions, that's why, okay, what we did against the event, what we did against the warm-up games, what we did against the, all the things like that. Mm-hmm. We all, even,
fair
that's
enough.
Why it's fair enough chance to win, because 20% is like, okay, China pretty ball, so now, Wahabia's ball or something.
Let's look at one of the things we've been doing on this panel was talking about who will be in the quarterfinals, who will be in the semifinals, and who will be in the finals. Can you take a stab at it? Like, in a quarterfinals, do you see any surprises to quarterfinals?
Because they need top 8 teams, right?
Right.
The surprises?
Mm.
I would say you never know about Afghanistan.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Because yesterday I played Afghanistan in my quarterfinals.
Because, you know, you never know about Afghanistan because they are... I'm talking about the gutsy.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
They're fearless. They have nothing to lose.
Mm.
Right?
Mm.
They have nothing to lose. Because like Ireland and UAE also, but UAE is different because
that's
UAE,
right.
Because of my son plays up 100% playing as a professional.
Right.
Mm. UAE knows like that.
I see.
UAE, they work in their companies and they play on the cricket, right? They're not fully professional cricketers from
right.
UAE.
Mm-hmm.
Same as Ireland. Maybe yeah. Ireland is now changing, but Afghanistan players, their job is to play a cricket.
Yes.
Right.
So
that's why they are not fear. They are not worried about that, okay, what happened. But UAE
mm-hmm.
and Ireland, they have certain elements involved
mm-hmm.
in their performance.
I
right?
see. No.
Yeah.
So I got some weight
can
now.
Be a surprise.
I got a weight of Asif Bhai.
Can be a surprise of Afghanistan.
Yes. And that's not only that, Asif Bhai, the reason I thought Afghanistan, it's good for cricket. You know, it's always about these 8 teams. It's good for that country itself who's going through so much trauma.
There should be,
you know,
Kenya.
There's something, you know, to put it together, you know, for the country to come in. So I really, and they're the underdog. And somehow I'm always with the underdogs, you know, like I want them to do that, you know. So
yeah. So how about the semis? Who are your teams in the semis?
Because again, when top 8 teams go into the semi quarterfinal, and there's one game.
Right.
Who played that one?
Correct.
Well, according to the first, New Zealand, South Africa, Australia, these three definitely
looks like we are
there,
right?
Yes.
And on the other, one team is going to be Pakistan, India,
West Indies,
England.
I mean,
Sri Lanka is yeah. We can
again the
fourth spot is kind of
yeah.
Good.
But you never know that even the record of the South African teams is not good. But I'm talking about they are. Current performances. Yeah.
Don't we want a subcontinental team, at least one from?
I put if you ask if this World Cup is going a different part of the world, I will not include New Zealand.
Yes. Yeah.
Because New Zealand in their own country, they are totally different
team.
On playing again.
And especially with the wind and all, right? They know how to.
Yeah, that's why I put New Zealand because they are playing their own conditions and they always did well in their own condition.
Still, who would be your fourth one? I think we all picked up ours. So your fourth one, who would be there?
Based not on the heart.
Based on the performances, I was looking for the England actually.
No England.
Okay. How about in the finals?
It looks like to be Australia.
Okay.
Right. And South Africa.
I thought New Zealand and South Africa.
But this time I think South Africa will break his
their jinx.
Break
yeah.
their jinx.
Yeah.
All right. So looks like we come to the top of the mark, and it was a great. I cannot tell you how nice it was. And here's what I was thinking. Let's here's the deal. On 15th, thank you. Best of luck to you and your team. After 15th, not before that. So and let's say we'll meet again all the way in the finals, and let's sit here. India and Pakistan in the final, hopefully.
Oh,
and then we'll talk about it again. Right, how about that?
If India and Pakistan go into the final,
mm-hmm.
then ICC and the other people and then all this World Cup era, then there will be boost by not economically, right? That
right.
is good for everybody, right?
Right. Let's
I'll open a t-shirt shop in Dallas.
let's aim for that.
Right.
And thanks a lot. And we are going to... thanks you for coming again.
Thank
and we'll stop the broadcast here this time.